Yeah, no, I'm obviously happy to be back home in the country and also excited to be part of some football initiatives, especially in youth development, like in a tournament like the Engine Challenge, which is a tournament that is also very special to me because I used to coach in this tournament while I was still an academy coach at Orlando Pirates. And I also used to be a selector at this tournament when I was still a national coach, working with the under 17 Amajimbos, under 20 national team Amajita, the Olympic team under 23, and then of course even Bafana Bafana as an assistant coach. So a tournament of this nature has always allowed us as coaches to observe, the best playing against the best. This tournament has laid a platform for a lot of promising young players, the likes of Teboho Mokoena, the likes of Jordi February, Fakhri Lakhe, Grant Marjaman. Jaden Adams is doing well now for Stellenbosch. I see Ozwin Apolice as well is doing well for Polokwane City. Tashrick Matthews is also excelling at Mamelodi Sundowns. So the list goes on, and the tournament has also created a beautiful platform for coaches as well. A lot of coaches that we are seeing now at performance level, the likes of Arthur Zwane, the likes of Rulani Mokoena, a lot of coaches, Thabo Septemba, they've all coached at this level. So it's a tournament that gets to put some talents in the on the platform, and it also helps with the life skills element of it because you want to produce a holistic player, and the players get to interact a lot with players from other academies. Coaches have to interact and communicate a lot in between matches, share ideas, share knowledge, share concepts, share methodologies. So it's a beautiful tournament, it's a beautiful program, and we want to thank Engine once again because without corporate companies, it's very difficult to work to get programs that can be able to help us unleash the talents that we have in abundance in our country. Yeah, no, of course. Look, the tournament have set a beautiful pace as far as talent scouting is concerned. But I just feel that we need to get more club scouts. I would love to encourage our PSL clubs to send more scouts in this kind of tournaments because they'll get to find youngsters that are ready to get into their respective DDC reserve sides and eventually progress into their respective senior teams. But I would also love to see this tournament getting a lot of international scouts because we all know that, exporting players, it's very effective when you send players abroad when they are as early as 18, 19, 20, so that they can be able to get another 18, 24 months of adapting and accelerating their development in a foreign country. So an under 18 tournament like Engine can always create a beautiful platform for players to be scouted and to move out of the country as early as possible because the earlier the better, because they are able to develop their adaptation skills in a foreign country, in a foreign league. Because we don't want to see international scouts coming into our country, into our professional league to scout players that are already in their mid-20s, in their late-20s, because then get exported, then they badly takes them time, and then it affects a lot of things, their game, their confidence, their development, and that also contributes positively or negatively to Bafana Bafana, because we know that if we want to have an excellent Bafana Bafana team, we have to have a lot of players, a bigger pool of quality players playing in the CAF Champions League space and playing in competitive leagues abroad. So then our respective national team coaches will be able to have bigger pool to select from, because that's how successful footballing nations are able to excel, because they always have a bigger pool. Look at a country like France, South American national teams. They always have bigger pools because of the number of players that have been exported in various competitive leagues across the globe. Exactly. Our football is growing, our football is developing, and I'm happy that we are able to see our football having different programs and also different leagues that are stimulating young talents like the DDC League and now the Engine Tournament. So I think our young players are in good hands. We just need to also fast track the coach education and coach development, because this talent needs to be touched by highly skilled, well-equipped coaches as far as knowledge is concerned, skills are concerned, passion or desire to research is concerned. So that's where I also come in, because I'm also assisting the SAFA Coach Education Department as one of the instructors, just to accelerate the development of coaches, as much as we increase in the number of licensed coaches, but also making sure that they get their licenses, but they also get education. Education in respect to the global game, different perspectives with our experiences, having worked in different parts of the world and having also attended different tournaments internationally. So I'm actually happy that I'm back, and I'm actually also happy that I'm interacting with coaches in a good space, which are coaching platforms like workshops and courses, because that's where we get to measure where we are as a country in terms of knowledge, in terms of research, and in terms of performance and analytics and the modern way of approaching the game and developing the players. It's very important to evolve with the modern trends. Let's readjust our teaching styles, because today's youth, they learn differently. You know, they are digital students. They are stimulated by audiovisual teaching. Let's put a lot of analytics in preparations for training, in preparations for matches. Let's respect sports science as well, just to accelerate the physical performance, the physical components of the players, because we could see that the game has changed a lot. Players have to be stronger, faster, to be able to maintain good actions for longer periods in a match. You could see how the North African clubs and national teams have really excelled and have really created a bit of a gap between North African football and maybe East Central African football and COSAFA SADC football. So it's always important that we work hard as coaches to make sure that we close the gaps between ourselves as South Africa and the rest of the world, while at the same time appreciating our own characteristics and skills as a country, our nature of artistry, of creativity. So we learn, we look at how the world are approaching the game, but we don't throw our own characteristics as well. We respect them, we use them as our base, and then we just try to refine them, you know, as far as structural football is concerned, as far as the tactics are concerned.